Hi, and welcome to the Never Cast Off podcast. Here we are on location in somebody's living room instead of their basement. My name is Debbie. I'm Deb Sesame on Ravelry, Instagram, and Etsy. And this is Blue Yarn Always on social media. My name is Sheila, and we're coming to you from Michigan. We're in Michigan right now. We live in Michigan. This is a Michigan podcast.
And you know what? In 10 minutes, we'll still be in Michigan.
We will be. It's September 23rd. It's a Friday night. This is usually therapy night, aka knit night.
Yeah.
But therapy, there's not a lot of members that need therapy this week.
Yeah. Our therapy was canceled.
Me and Debbie need therapy.
Apparently.
So you're in our Friday night knit night with us.
Yes, so this is Friday night.
So welcome to therapy.
Welcome to therapy. That's the name of the show.
Right, I'm going to write that down. Welcome to therapy.
Okay, so what we're doing is we're going to first go through what some of the morning announcements are. And
we
have some folks that said hi to us, and we're not too embarrassed to say on the internet hi to us. So thank you. So Helen.
Helen, she's Sprite966, and she also has a YouTube channel. You should check her out, Crocheter, Knitter, Dyer, Spinner. Hi, Helen.
Hi, Helen. And then we have Virginia.
And her Ravelry ID is Mattachel.
Mattachel.
Mattachel. Virginia.
Hi, Virginia.
And then
Sarah.
We have Sarah. And she's one of the sisters of the Reluctant Sisters podcast. And they also have a YouTube channel if you want to check them out. It's three sisters, and they knit, and I believe they crochet.
What, is she the one that's reluctant?
I don't know, but there's three of them, three sisters.
Okay.
I mean, that's kind of odd that you all have the same craft.
Well,
I would think. I mean, none of my sisters are interested in any crafty things. None of them.
Hmm. Yeah,
which is
I don't
odd.
Know.
And then we also had a tip in from a member of our Ravelry group, Angela. She lives in Lupton, Michigan, and her Rav ID is Angel. She's posted in the group about a fiber festival this weekend, and it's Northern Michigan Lamb and Wool Festival in West Branch. So if you don't have anything to do, which I wish I didn't have anything to do,
yeah,
I would go.
Too.
But it's a fiber festival in West Branch this weekend, Saturday and Sunday. So if you go, please let us know what you got. Post pictures.
Yeah, we like pictures.
Yes, I want to see pictures. And as far as the morning announcements, I think that's it.
Well, actually, there's one more.
Okay, one more.
I'm taking management class, and they want us to do a project. And I'm just trying to figure out what my project is. And so I remember when my sister-in-law was pregnant, and she ended up giving birth to a baby that was not fully developed. And there's so many preemies, and there's so many little children that are born like that. And these parents go through the whole thing of the childbirth, and sometimes their baby doesn't survive. And being able to leave the hospital with something or anything really means a lot to them. So I was wondering if anybody was interested in doing like the little hats for preemie babies. And then that would be something that...
knit or crochet?
Knit, crochet, quilt, doesn't matter.
Okay.
So if you guys wanted to do something like that, please let me know if you're interested. It's going to be a quick project if there's interest. So if you could let me know, I would really, really appreciate it. So Deb's Destiny.
Or leave a message on Ravelry under episode 47 or on YouTube or PM Debbie or get her on Instagram. There's several ways you can get a hold of her. I can think of five.
Ooh. Yeah, but you can just text me. They don't have my phone number.
No, but you can message her on Etsy. They can message you on Instagram. They can message you on Ravelry. They can go on YouTube. And they can also go on the episode thread in the group. So there's five ways.
Okay.
So if you're interested, say something.
Yep.
Say something, most definitely. So I'll put that down in the morning announcements. Preemie has interest. Got it. Any escapees?
Nope. How about you?
I had two and they're gone, so I do not have them to show. However, they're on my, well, nope. Let's see. I made another vanilla cone. I went to a 10-year-old's birthday party. She was excited to get it, but I didn't make a project page for it because I've made a couple already.
And that's the one, the little cone that looks like an ice cream cone.
Yeah,
so
it's a stuffy. It's a stuffy.
Yeah.
And then the other one was the honey cowl, and that was out of the Malintosh. And I already sent that off to Belinda, the lady I was making it for. Because there was no sense in me holding it for another 9 days. But it's on my project page. The pattern's very easy, and it's a free pattern on Ravelry.
Cool.
The honey cowl. So escapees have escaped.
Whee!
Yeah, they're gone. So we got hanging on the wire.
Well, right now, I am working on this. It is a very, very simple. It's going to be a cowl.
Looks like a garden. You know the colors?
Yeah, it really does.
Yeah, it does. It's pretty.
Yeah. So it goes
diagonal?
It ends up going diagonal because I'm knitting.
You want me to hold this?
Knitting. Yeah, let me. You this is yarn a, over and knit two together.
Is this your pattern or pattern of Ravelry?
Yeah, it's mine.
Okay.
And so it just it does go at an angle, so when you look at it, it's cool how it's running.
That's the silk yarn.
It is silk, and I know somebody wants to know what it is, and so we can have it say it. It is the Yarns of Richard DeVries. Just says 100% raw silk, 225 yards. So it doesn't necessarily have a color that it feels like mentioning. So, yeah, I just
you could use all of it.
Yep. That's the beauty of doing it this way instead of in the round. If you go in the round, you have to try and yarn chicken it, and then you either have a whole bunch or not enough. But if you do it this way, then there's less yarn waste, at least for me. But it's something that it does. Sometimes the ones in the round are prettier, but yeah. So
you just have shorter rows, right?
Yeah, shorter rows. Yeah. Yeah, for me, if you do like six of the is it stacking that? No, that's not. The
garter.
Six garter on the top, you want six garter on the bottom. But then you have to plan for it, and you have to make sure you use the right amount of yarn and everything like that, plus the cast off. So I just, it really is easier doing it this way for me. So
whatever works.
I think it's cool how it's going to go sideways. Here, can you hold this? Mm-hmm. It's going to go like this. So it'll be, it will, it really will be at a diagonal. The color,
right.
The color runs at a diagonal.
It's nice.
So it's going to be nice and soft too.
Yeah. Once you wash it,
yeah,
that's, it'll go into full silk mode.
Yeah. So it's a little rough right now. So it'll be less rough later.
That's cool. Let's see.
Okay, so what you got hanging on the wire?
Well, camp side. I had to do a 30 row rip out.
Ouch. I can't believe I keep yawning. I'm sorry.
We're keeping you up?
Yeah, apparently. At the end 30 rows?
No, so I'm doing this with the Sprite 966 group on Ravelry. She has a knit along fall, slide into fall. So This right here is the rip out. So I'm a crocheter, if you're new to the podcast. And as I was knitting this, and of course I didn't rip it all the way back. I mean, I could have, but you see the little, can you pull on the bottom? Nope, down here. See like the little teeny holes here and there? They're very little. As long as I can see those holes, it doesn't bother me. But doing the yarn overs, it's a free pattern, doing the yarn overs, I was yarning over as if I was crocheting, which is not correct in knitting. Thus, there was no holes. So as I'm just knitting, watching TV, whenever I'm knitting, kind of looked up and I gave it a little pull and I was like, where's the holes? All I seen was these X's. Then I realized what I did. So I'm making this for my mother. And this is yarn that she purchased from Swoon Fibers. What was it flips up on me?
I don't think she would have minded.
No, but that would have drove me nuts. And this is the yarn right here. It's very fallish. As she pointed out the other day, she's like, oh, it's very springy. She's like, look how springy that yarn is. I'm like, I don't know what that means. What does that mean? It's springy. But if you bunch it in a ball, it's going to pop back up to its regular spot.
When you go like this, and you go like that. But I don't know what the significance of that is. It's very squishy.
So this ball of yarn here was actually in this. And this is the new row right here, starting correctly. So about 30 rows back, give or take. So, Helen, I'm not going to make it. There's no way I'm going to make it on the deadline. Because now I have to actually pay attention. Because in the meantime, I was crocheting. And then as your muscle memory, and I'm just crocheting. And then I go to knitting. And my hand knows the knitting to do this. But the yarn overs, what was I doing? Like I'm crocheting instead of coming up in the front. It wasn't. So yeah, this is the campsite shawl, Lisa Plummer. So that is one hanging on the wire. And then I picked up another project for someone I don't know. And I'm making a shawl for them out of Lucky.
Oh, that's bright.
Yes, this is the hottest. This is 100% cashmere, 280 yards. And the color is called CC Bloom. See?
Inspiration Beaches.
Inspiration Beaches. But yeah. 100% cashmere. I don't want to know anyone else of this now.
Aww.
So anyway, this is a paper pattern on Ravelry. It's called The Herald. And I have a project page going. So she sent me two balls that are wound up. And then a couple skeins. And this is where, I think, this is the front and this is the back. Very asymmetrical. Is this what you call asymmetrical pattern?
I've done.
Yeah. This is the pattern. So of course I have to pay attention to this one too.
That's very soft.
Yeah. This is, it shows up very baby pink on the screen, but this is like electric pink.
Hot pink.
Yeah. It's very, very soft. Cashmere. I'm spoiled now. My hands will never be the same. But and what else? I'm still working on socks, the Heritage Prints, but I don't have them to show, so I will save those for another time. So that's what I got for hanging on the wire. So getting your knitting on.
I got nothing.
Got nothing? Hold on, I'll be right back.
So this is where everybody wants me to tell a story. Trying to think of a story to sell.
Sell or tell?
Oh, tell. Okay, here we go.
Let me get back in my chair.
I was at the Secretary of State, DMV, where whatever you want to call it.
Secretary of State.
Yeah. So it was one of those things where you had to keep going back because it wasn't just for one trip wasn't enough. And we're standing in the return line, and the idea of the return line is the next person that's available, you get to go up there.
You don't have to wait in line behind 500 people anymore.
Right. Well, for the return line.
Yep.
And so four people got a hold of, were called ahead of us. And I'm like, well, what the heck? I don't think they see it. So it's me and my husband standing there. I'm like, I don't think they see us. Really.
They weren't waving you up?
They were not calling us. And that's just like one after the other.
That's
they
mean.
Were calling at the other folks, and it's like, okay.
Turn line goes first.
I am going to try something. I warned my husband ahead of time. Now, motion catches the eye. That's just the way that I forget where I learned that, psychology or whatnot. So I start doing these big gestures, and I actually had my thing, and I said, and I'm going like this, and I'm just real big gestures. I mean, it's a huge room. Huge room.
And people thought you were having an attack.
I don't know. I'm like, well, I don't know, just do whatever I can think of to
stretch,
and within 30 seconds, return line, and I'm like, oh my word. I'm like, see, honey, I told you it would work. Okay. So there's your story. You're back.
So you got up to the DMV line.
Yeah.
That's nice. I hate going to the DMV.
Yeah. We know most of the folks there now. We had to go back 5 times.
Oh my God. Thank God it's over with.
Yes.
Where did I go? Oh, I went to go get for getting your knitting on. So I plan on starting the Pure Joy.
Oh, it looks joyful.
Oh my God, I still want to make that. So I wound up the yarn, and this yarn I wound up Undead Yarn, and this is the Vampire Midnight Roadkill, 75 superwash merino, 25% nylon. 462 yards. I wound that up. And then look, I wound up my
mill ends.
My Stonehenge mill ends, which will be working with this.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Because there is some striping. And I think I'm going to use the Stonehenge mill ends for the dark stripe. So I'm going to be using Undead for the white, and I'm going to be using the mill ends for the stripe and this last dark part. So I don't know if that's B or A, but this is going to be the roadkill, and then this is going to be striped in. I think it's going to look nice.
Well, it's going to be beautiful.
I think it's really going to look good. So I have all of that ready. So, oh my God, next time I want to knit something for somebody, I think I'm going to have to text the therapy group and say, please stop me. Please help me.
Because
I can't do my own because I have deadlines on this knitting that I want to knit. I don't know what's wrong with me. I need a meeting. And nobody's here for the meeting. But
I'm here.
I know you're here. Thank you.
You're welcome.
I need a meeting. Need a therapy meeting. So that's for getting your knitting on.
Don't we all need therapy meetings?
I do need. There's a coworker that I have, and ever since I met you and I started going to the yarn shop. She's the one that came up with it. Every Friday she would ask me because she would see me getting all my bags together. She'd be like, "Where are you going?" I'm like, "Going to the knitting store." And she's like, "Oh, you're going to therapy." And I'm like, "Why do you say that?" And she's like, "Cause all you doing is you guys like shit. You sit, you share, you vent. You feel better, you knit, you leave." And I'm like, yeah. So every Friday for the past 5 years, her name is Betsy. She doesn't watch the podcast. Every Friday.
Thank you, Betsy. You rock.
Every Friday when I'm leaving work, she's like this. Therapy. I'm like, yes. And people just look at me and I'm like, yeah, I'm off therapy. I don't say nothing. Like, oh, she's a crazy woman. Stay away from her desk.
It's like one of those things that they're afraid to ask.
Yeah.
But that's what makes it even more fun.
Yeah, she's like, therapy? I'm like, yep. People never ask me, like, what kind of therapy are you going to? They just look at me. Nobody will ask. They just look at
anybody
me.
Anybody want to come with me? It's group therapy.
They're probably like, no, I'm not paying the deductible.
There's no deductible. You just have to come.
No, they're probably, well, a lot of them don't know me. Maybe they actually think that I'm going to therapy. I have no idea. So, let's see. DIY. I made 2 skeins of yarn.
Whee!
1 skein I love. Let me get out here. And the other skein, not so much. So, this loveliness of fallish loveliness. I think I showed the bobbins on the podcast. Is this was 4 ounces of merino, and that was in the colors, and then there was the 4 ounces of the white, and you called it mohair because that was the mystery yarn, mystery okay. fiber, like mystery meat. So I just put it, I got my little card there.
That's not the one back from Stonehenge Fiber yet, is it?
No.
Okay. I would have heard about it.
And these little cards are just fabulous. So I filled it out. So it's merino and mohair. I got 262 yards, and it's a 2-ply. And these little cards here, if you're a spinner, because I used to use the business cards, you can get them, I believe, she's on Etsy. But these are the cards, and this is who you'll get in contact with. And they're terrific. So this is just like, it's got a bath. Smells good. But yeah, it's 2-ply. You know, one bobbin was chained upon the other bobbin. So, yeah, I like it. It's, what is it, a worsted? Would you say that's a worsted? It's not a fingering, for God, no. Maybe a worsted.
Worsted, a thick worsted.
A thick worsted.
A very thick worsted.
So, I'm really happy with this.
Aaron.
An Aaron? Okay.
I would call it Aaron.
I think this came out really nice. I really, really
I think
like
it's
it.
It's beautiful.
I like it. It's very fallish. So I got 262 yards. So Whee! This is terrific.
So, oh, wait. You could actually put it over your head right now.
Oh, my
that's
God.
That's what a cowl would look like.
Okay, well, we'll pretend.
I've
been in menopause for 7 years, and it could be snowing outside and 6 inches of snow, and I'm in the house in shorts and a tank top with fan blowing. So here.
No,
you don't want to? I just need this. Menopause hot flashes to end.
Okay.
So my niece, I found out recently, likes the color green. So I believe I had a 4-ounce braid of merino when me and Debbie were first doing the dyeing. And I dyed it, which I will never dye fiber. I will never dye braids again, fiber braids again. I will dye yarn, but I will never dye the roving.
Okay.
So this is 4 ounces of merino that I think I might have used Kool-Aid. I don't even remember.
Yeah, I don't think we
Or Debbie, had. The last of Debbie's dye. I'm not sure. But there's a little bit of yellow in here, and it's a really vibrant green.
The only way it would have been that vibrant green with the dyes that I had would have been with teal. And so it would have been the chartreuse, which could possibly be this, but this to me doesn't look like it's the right color.
So the only other thing this could be is Kool-Aid. So this is probably a Kool-Aid, probably what is it, lemon lime, and probably God knows what. I didn't write it down because I don't have a dyer's notebook. Do you have a dyer's notebook?
No.
You should get a dyer's notebook.
You should too.
Yeah. You got more yarn to dye than I do. It's good for like experimenting, they said. Like if you really like a colorway, you would remember.
Okay.
I don't know. Anyway.
I think that's a good idea.
Yeah, we need to get your dyer's notebook. So this is merino. I got 79 yards. So what I did is I filled up one bobbin because I wanted to keep the color. There's a lot of just yellow. Right there. There's a lot of yellow. And I would say this is a sport. This is sport.
I'd say worsted.
You'd say worsted? Okay, worsted. So what I did is I took one bobbin and I plied it on itself off the one bobbin. I think they call it Navajo plying, where you have the big loop on your wrist and you're pulling it through off the one bobbin. I've only done this like maybe three times, and as you can tell, this has already had a bath. My twist is like twisted. I mean, too much twist. So I got 79 yards out of 4 ounces, and she's going to get mitts with these. This is the only Christmas knitting, I guess, that I have left to do is just make Tina some mitts. And I might even crochet these.
Cool.
Just to see what it works up with. But I don't know. See how much twist is in there? There's just like too much energy in there. The twist is just like...
intense twister.
Yeah, this is an intense twister. But this is, yeah, the spinning, but... I don't know, maybe I'll crochet it and it'll work a little bit better. But it's cute. I will, yeah, never dye a roving knee, no more. And then I also, now that I have all my bobbins empty, I have this, which is very fallish, and I already took it out. And I got it ready to go. And this is hand-painted roving Tiger Lily from Greenwood Fiberworks on Etsy. And this is BFL. You know what this feels like? It reminds me of touching a cat. And I got this from the Moms with Yarn podcast, I believe, a couple months ago. It's very nice. I should have a spinner's notebook. I do have a notebook on the fibers that I really, really like, but I haven't spun with just straight BFL. But look, that's got a long staple in it. Look, it keeps going and going and going.
Pretty. Here you go. I'm getting it organized for you.
You're doing a little, you're doing the braid? But well, this is very pretty and it's very fallish.
I don't know what else to do with it.
Yeah, I'm going to start when I take a break from knitting. And hopefully I don't mess nothing else up. But there is it. I just ripped the paper. And I don't know if the Etsy shop's still available, but ain't that cute? It's little sheep going to the tree. It's cute.
It's very nice.
So that's what I have for DIY.
Oh, for DIY.
DIY.
I ended up going to Stonehenge Fiber. And I'm not done with this yet. I guess this is my next DIY right here.
Where?
Right here.
Oh, you're winding out. Okay, because I got to pull all that back out, girl.
What?
Yeah, I got to get it on the wheel.
Well, can't you just use this part?
And then just because I'm going to rip it in pieces, like strips and then strips. Because I don't want to spin from the knuckle, or they call spin from the pole. I don't like doing that. So, yeah. Okay. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for participating.
She took it away from me. Sorry, Sheila.
That's okay.
So, when I was there, I ended up finding the bargain bin. A bin. It was real bad.
At a fiber mill.
Oh, my word.
Lucky dog.
$6. And they have a whole bunch of stuff there.
$6.
$6 for a skein of yarn like this. And it's just amazingly soft. It's just so nice. But the twist on it was a little wimpy. So I said, Sheila, will you please put a little bit more twist? And so she just gave it back to me twisted.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Yeah.
So I have that. And then when we went to, where was it? The Michigan Fiber Festival?
Allegan.
Allegan. Take me away. Remember that commercial?
Allegan, take me away.
So I ended up getting some stuff from the Fiber Pusher. And I ended up getting 3 ounces of alpaca and 3 ounces of Shetland wool.
Ooh, so, and one's called Almond, and the one's called Almond Joy.
Yep, Almond Joy. And so.
Jeez, they wrap it up like Fort Knox.
Well, that's good. We didn't want to, like, with the way the weather was, we wouldn't want it to blow away.
No.
So
definitely sure.
So what happens is I'm hoping to have it spun for me where like this is on one bobbin and that one's on the other bobbin and then you put them together.
This is Almond Joy. This must be the name of the Shetland. The Shetland must be named Almond Joy. There's no nuts in here. Almond Joy has nuts. Mounds doesn't. I know my candy bar.
And this is alpaca.
Alpaca. Oh my god, that's so soft. It looks like pencil roving.
It really does. I'm looking at it, I'm like, well, yeah, but without the twist, it'll peel up real fast.
You know what's the nice thing about buying from Bonita? Is you can buy it by the ounce, which
yeah.
I like. There's no, like, pre-made braids. Not that I don't like those either. I do, but... Like, I could be like, I need 2 ounces of that, 4 ounces of that, 6 ounces of that, or if I'm running a little short.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I like that you can buy it by the ounce, which is really cool. So, you want the alpaca and the Shetland spun together?
Yeah, so you put one on one bobbin, one on the other, and then twist them.
Then you make the magic happen.
Yeah. Then what we're going to do is we're going to dye it.
Yes, we are.
And because it's a little bit different of the animal fiber is different, it's going to pick up different colors.
Yes, most definitely. She kind of forewarned you on that one.
Yeah. So
I have like a whole chandelier of bags, but I will show them as I work on them, I guess.
Do you need me to come up with another story?
No. Because, I mean, Ann Arbor Fair is coming up here, too, when we plan on going. And if anybody else is going, make a comment in the thread. Or because if you're there and we're there, we can meet up and say
and
hey.
Please say hi.
Get a hug and a picture.
Rita stopped us, and we actually got to talk to Rita.
Yeah. Debbie's the type that I want a picture. So.
Yeah.
She'll stand behind you and be like, I want a picture.
Well, I mean, it was really cool. So, we're thinking about Sunday.
For all the Fiber Festival?
Yeah.
Is it Sunday?
It's Saturday or Sunday.
Saturday or Sunday. And if you're in the Ann Arbor area, we get closer to the date. We're definitely going to go. I mean, I guess we're going as a therapy group. So, we'll have to,
knitting. Yeah.
Our therapy posse.
I have this big, so I ended up getting a minivan. Okay. It's just me.
So you could haul around like kids and pets and.
I mean, it's got the two front and two rows. It's like a 7-passenger
and it's just
minivan.
You.
And it's just me.
I don't know what to tell you.
I feel like, okay, I think you heard this story before. I feel like going and getting, like, stuffed animals.
Oh, yeah, yeah,
and,
yeah.
Like, seatbelting them in.
Yeah, she wants to go get, like, 4 or 5 foot stuffed animals and then put them in the back seat like a
and
big
then,
bear
and then, like,
or.
Belt them in.
What
and
do we
then,
say, a
and
giraffe?
Then put, yeah, and then put, like,
hats,
know,
on,
hats
them,
on
big sunglasses.
And then it's like, well, at least there's something in the pack. It just would be hilarious when I'm going to college with all of the college students. And I have a minivan.
They would think you need therapy. Those are my friends.
Yeah. Oh my gosh. I talk to them. but they don't talk back.
Yeah, sometimes those are the best friends to have.
Because you can say whatever and they don't say anything.
Yeah. Listen, little bear, stop playing around with your sister back there.
Oh, my goodness.
You know, and then I don't want to tell my husband about it. Could you imagine coming home and he works afternoons or whatever? And so it's
he
just,
sees all the people in the minivan.
He sees all this crap. And he's like, what the heck is that? He'll be just standing there going, you know, and it's just. Like, prepare it for.
He would think that you went to the carnival and you cleaned up.
And it just, well, I mean, there was one time we did have a purple orangutan or something like that. And he did. He had it seatbelted in the front
did
seat
he?
Of the car. So, yeah, but I'm not telling him about it. So then the surprise of it will be priceless.
Yeah, that would be
okay,
hilarious.
Okay, so what else do you got?
I got Satellite Store.
Knock it out.
And I got a giveaway. Don't tell nobody.
Okay.
Okay, we got to tell.
Okay.
So I posted on Instagram, got a cake. I did. I went to Michael's and I bought a cake and I blame it on Kim, the crafty nomad. I blame it on her.
Kim.
Because I follow her on Instagram.
Do we need to have a chat?
Yep. Okay. So I bought one and I bought one for you. Because as I've learned, there's a lot of people that don't have a Michael's store near them.
Oh, my.
So since I like this color, I'm assuming everybody's going to like the same color I like, right?
Well, of course.
So this color is called, what's it called? Cake Pop. Oh, get out. It's called Cake Pop. That's weird. Who'd want to eat a gray cake? That's weird. Anyway, one is mine. One is yours. I will be putting up a thread in the group, and you're going to have to answer the question and follow the rules. So somebody's going to get a cake.
Just cause.
So
there.
Oh, and then I also got this in. So I ordered, I seen this on Ravelry, you know, those little pop-up ads. So, of course, what did I do? I'm on break. I'm on the phone. I'm done with Instagram. This is the card. Dancing Leaf Farm, and they're out of Maryland. What did I buy? They have their own farm. They shear, they mill, they dye. So I bought two skeins of yarn from them.
Oh, they're scrunchy.
This is 50% alpaca, 50% wool, and the color is mermaid.
And this one is Polworth wool, 85% and 15%.
I have never knitted with Polworth. I have knitted with alpaca, but this is kind of cute. And the base is, this is 166 yards.
Dallas Davison, is that the name? No.
It might be.
Hand wash. No, that's not it.
Is it on the front?
Could you imagine? You should call one of them hand wash.
This is in the wall space, and I think that's in the hustle base.
Hustle.
Yeah, it's cute though. I have never knitted with Polworth. Have you?
No.
And you can really tell the difference. I can tell the difference.
Oh wow, I really are.
You can tell the difference. Oh,
alpaca.
And then washi tape. Oh my god.
Oh boy.
Who needs washi tape? Not me. So yeah, I did. This is at Michael's. 44 rolls of washi tape every holiday season is in the box. Mm-hmm. Terrific. So, and I'm also in a washi tape swap on Ravelry. In the friends swap group, and I just got a message that she sent out my washi tape swap. So
cool.
She gave me a tracking number. So I'm curious to see what that is, but I will, you as my witness, I will not be in any more washi tape swaps. I already have 20 rolls of my own. plus 44, and God knows how many this lady's going to send me from the washi tape swap. She said she liked the tape that I sent her, which is really cool. So it's always nice when you send something to somebody and they're like, oh, I liked it, instead of going, geez, you know. But she said she liked it, which is really cool.
So I ended up joining one of the, a swap.
Did you join a swap?
I did. It's for Christmas.
Ooh.
So I guess we have some time, but I don't know.
Christmas swap? Yeah. I think I did that last year.
You did.
I did do it.
So I'm in that one this year. And I think the spending limit's $25.
That's cool.
Is inexpensive, but it's just, okay, I'm not exactly sure what to get $25, but that's fine.
You have to look for sales.
I like $25, so.
I look for sales.
Yeah, so it'll be interesting.
And then I won.
Again.
Oh, here. Packing Its Designs on Etsy. This is my first DPN holder, cozy.
Cool.
So let me know when you get to the end of the row. So I have the Force.
May the Force be with you.
Now I have the Force in my knitting bag. Everybody needs Force, right?
Mm-hmm.
Ain't these the coolest? I don't have any. This may become my new obsession. But anyway, let me know when you get to the row. And she also sent two pixie sticks.
Oh, cool.
There you go.
Oh.
And she lives in Florida, and she also has a YouTube channel, Packing Knits Design Podcast, Heidi. Oh, look, a little progress keeper.
Oh, that is so.
So as
it's a little sandal.
So as I'm sitting here in the next couple months, and I'm freezing my butt off, and it's, I don't know, 13 degrees outside with 2 feet of snow, I'm going to look at this and think of sunny Florida.
Okay, I'm at the end of the row.
Okay, so let me see your, it's not for your hand, it's for your needles.
I don't know what you want.
I think this is how it works. I'm not a real professional on it. But I don't have any DPNs going right now. So basically, and if I'm doing this wrong, please say something. Remember, we're in therapy. We can talk to each other. Look. So now you can throw it in your bag and no stitches are going to slide off. I might have it wrong, but I think this is right. I've watched a
you
few podcasters.
Double point needles.
Yep. It's a DPN holder. But a lot of people don't use DPNs. They use on their circulars. And look, see?
Okay, so the
okay,
the,
but
these are not the double point needles.
So let's just say you have
so put them
you,
in there.
Yep, and you have socks on there. See? They're not coming out.
Oh.
And then your work's hanging here. We are new to this. Both of us are new.
I thought it was just you put your double point needles in there.
It's not a storage container. You use it for your work. So you don't lose your work. I'll have to do something on DPNs. But I've seen a lot of people to where instead of doing these.
So you could go la 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 la.
Yep. And click those in. Yep. You're getting a lesson in DPNs here.
But these aren't DPNs.
Nope. Oh, a DPN holder. Or I've heard people call them cozies too. I don't think they're very cozy, but I like holder. Ain't that cute? Yep, there you go. So now I'm going to have the Force in my knitting bag. I'm telling you.
Okay, so then
everybody needs the Force. Look at that.
Then my thing won't, like, slide off.
Yep. Ain't that the greatest invention ever?
That's pretty cool.
Yep. So thank you, Heidi. I love my DPN holder. And if you need a DPN holder, check out her website, Packy Knits Designs at Etsy, and get yourself a DPN holder and be as fascinated with it as me and WR.
It doesn't take much for us on a Friday night, sorry.
Oh, it's been a long week. Okay.
So we are running out of time.
Yeah, I have one more thing to show really quick. Okay. I do. So I am going to start a collection. I'm going to start a collection on my Etsy shop, Thank God for Bags. And the collection will be pretty much up and running in the middle of October. And what the collection is going to be, it is going to be Zodiac bags. This is Sagittarius, and this is going to be the size of the bag. Each bag is going to have a holder with your sign, and they're going to be able to hold 1, 2, 3, 4 skeins of yarn, and on the inside, it's going to be the constellation. Look. Cool. Stars. Can't see it. It's kind of dark.
So this is really pretty.
That's so a juniper soft. Moon.
This is juniper moon.
It is.
Wool, alpaca, and silk. Oh my word.
But this is the Sagittarius. Oop. And depending on the way I cut it. But I did bring a couple just to show. These are not together yet, as I just washed the material. This would be Cancer. And it has a saying on it. The moon shares with Cancer that love of travel and adventure, the harmony for life, and a peaceful life. And I just brought Capricorn to show, which is really cool. I like the Capricorn because it's orange. Every fabric is going to be different. Every horoscope sign is going to be different. But all the insides will have the constellation of the stars. So you can find the Big Dipper and all of that. So stay tuned for that. That's going to be coming in October. And if you follow Thank God for Bags on Instagram, I'll probably put updates there just to see if there's any interest in horoscope bags. It's horoscope bags, Zodiac bags. And I did put a few in the Etsy shop. They're cute. Look at that little marker. It's a headset. So those foxes.
Classy fox wearing.
Isn't that cute?
Yep.
This is the last one I got of the tea bags right now. And these are all small bags. Very small. This is an envelope bag. So there's no, it's envelope style. This one's cool. I like this one. NASCAR. Check the flag.
Cool.
And who doesn't like giraffes?
This is cool.
And this is the handle. I think the inside is just yellow. But giraffes. So two large, three small. And stay tuned next month for the Zodiac bags. So I think that's it. There'll be a thread in Ravelry. So if you're not in our Ravelry group and you're interested in participating, it doesn't cost anything to join. You won't get bombarded with spam mail from Ravelry. But there that's where the giveaway is going to be. So if you want to follow us on Instagram, on our YouTube channel in the top corner over here, there's Debbie's link and my link. We want to thank you for all who have subscribed.
Thank you.
And for all of you who leave comments, we appreciate it and we read them all and respond back. So welcome to any new viewers. And if you're returning, God love you for watching.
Yeah. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Have a great week.
Yep. Happy Friday.